Hello, this is Rusty Dog, and welcome to Fun with Geysers. I was going to call it Geysers, but that'd be weird. Right, so before we get on with this, has anyone seen this before? All looks good from here. What the hell is this? I haven't worked it out. Why this is red. There's nothing here. Anyway, let's move on. Well, as you can see, I've spotted one from the asp, but I can't get down there. Look at the terrain. I'll try and bring this in a little bit closer. But that's the bottom of the ravine, which is why it's spitting out that way. But I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get a parking space down here. And even if I did, what do I do from there? We fly onto this or into it or... Interrupt its flow by being in its way. I don't know what we're getting washed with, but it can't be too healthy. And how the hell am I going to bring an SRV around here? Okay, maybe if I can land here, that would be nice. Yeah, we got a blue window there, so there's possibilities here. A blue window. Yeah, a window of opportunity. Anywhere down here would be cool, and if I can just not wander more than 3 kilometers away, then the ship won't have too much trouble coming back to me because it won't have to go anywhere in the first place. Oh, this is going to be very tricky. That's a bust. Here we go. That was a bigger window. Let's see if we can bring this thing down. Alright. Right then, so... plug in the old controller. I never had it ready. Okay. Let's go and meet a couple of geysers.
Low gravity warning.
Yes, it is low gravity here. Very much so. To be a bit careful around here. This is some very tricky terrain. Now then, this wave on the scanner, is that consistent with, is that a new one? No, it looks like it's something here. Oh, crystalline frags. I mean, what do you do with those? It's not like you can't pick them up, right? And if you destroy them. See, these craters are not active right now, but they can be, I think, at different times. I don't know if it's... is it a good thing or a bad thing to destroy these? I don't know. There we go. Oh, it gives you material. You can get chromium from a... okay. Right, where's that big geyser? Well, there's one there, but that's not the one, is it? Let's go back looking at the ship. Oh, you see what I mean? When we were approaching this, the jet stream out of here was a lot higher. I mean, look up there. There's two streams up there, just... See, you can see two of them? Three of them. There's one there, right in the middle of the screen, little one. And there's two up there. One of them's on the left there is gushing like crazy. There's one over there, which we can go and take a looky. And this one is, well, it's not much now. It used to be. And with low gravity on this planet, I wonder if... Nah, it's not strong enough. Not this one. It does change. That could really spout out later on. I wonder if I can get over here. I don't fancy my chances going up the side of that mountain on the left of me. Where's it gone? I know it's up ahead. I can see it. Well, of course it's compromised. You should tell me that at 99%. Come on. There's the stream. And this is a right gusher. Wow, look at this one. Not the one I'm looking at. I think there's another one here. Look at that. Whoa. Holy. Man, I wouldn't want to get on top of that. But I'm going to. That's a right... That's like a bloody oil well. I mean, this one's flung me a little bit in the air. 14 metres. What's the other one going to do? It's going to put me onto the surface of the next planet. Look at this one. Oh my God. Now I can... hardly see it, you know, what's gushing out. But look at the rate of this. Oh, wow, that's the strongest one I've seen. Well, I haven't seen many. Right, keep an eye on the altitude then. Oh, okay. 200 and 300. 300 and 400. And 463 metres we got shoved in the air there. I'm going to be in a little bit of trouble here. I'm going to try and keep this thing level. Wow. Now where the hell have I come down? How far away from the gusher? I can't hear it. My ship's... There's that... Now that gush is starting to gush again. Am I anywhere near where I was? I mean, it just flung me right up in the air there. You can't... That's my ship over there. Then I came along and turned right. Well, I think I've lost that big gusher. And the only way to find it... Oh, wait a minute, though. No. I was going to say, the only way to find it is to go back to the ship. But I think that gusher that I'm seeing there, the big one, above the 180 number on the top, is the one that I saw on the side of the mountain before. Which means I might have to go this way. or that big one that I just got thrown off. No, there's too much flat ground here. I didn't come across this before. That was a right gusher, wasn't it? That was an absolute cracker. It's a pity it wasn't made of more clearer liquid like the other one, but wow. There was some force to it. Now there's, wait a minute, there's the planet in the sky, the dark one that was there before. So maybe I am going in that direction. Well, let's have a look around here anyway. I have to keep reminding myself that I am actually on full beam. This looks like I'm just a little, like Fantastic Voyage, and I'm just on some moldy cheese or something. Now, Rusty, you need to stay. Rusty Asp Explorer, you need to stay where you are. So that I have a reference point. Well, there's another one up there, isn't it? No. I'm getting myself into some weird places here. I need to make my way back to Rusty's Asp. Oh my god, this looks a bit treacherous. There's quite a lot of inactive geysers right now. Okay, so I'm 380 meters away from the ship, and the challenge is to get there. Like, don't come across a path where it locks you in and you're done for. Okay, I've got sight of ship now, so we should be okay. Unless I nosedive into a rock. Yeah, I'm closer than I thought I was, so. And that's the back of the ship. Wait a minute. How the hell did I get all the way back here? What the hell did that geyser do when it threw me in the air? It's this way. Because this is where I got the crystalline fragment from here. And then I turned right because there was a massive gusher. Was it that one? Oh, I don't know which way I went now. I know I turned right. Ah! Tracks! Tracks. So I've been here before. But that big gusher might have stopped now. It's not a persistent flow all the time. I'm not seeing anything. The wave scanner is full of things pointing me towards gushy things. Let's see if I can get to that one. This'll be fun. Oh, I thought if I could just get a ramp up there, I could. Getting to that's going to be a tough one. Look at the slope that I'm on for a start. Oh, Oh, I mean, you just don't realise what kind of a slope you're on until you look at the scanner sometimes. There's the big gusher there. Come on! Oh, it feels like the gears on these, like the, you know, on this SRV is really having to struggle. Look at that gusher, that is an absolute cracker. Not this one, I mean this one's pretty good. Whoa, has that just changed to a liquidy thing? Right in front of our eyes, right there. And look, this one the closest to me looks like it's died down a bit. I'm trying to make this thing just move a little bit and it won't. I can't go forward. Oh, excuse me, my alarm's going off on my phone. Right. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Push, 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 push. Oh, just I only needed like a couple of feet more. I'm gonna go over the right hand side. I didn't want to, I wanted to get a shot from this side. But let's try again. There we go. Maybe I should make the handbrake a toggle, but it doesn't seem to be doing anything. This seems to be something in Beta 7 where it's just, even with the handbrake on, it's just moving. I know I'm on a big slope, but the gravity's... I shouldn't weigh anything. Okay, I'm being forced then to go down in this little bit here. Wow. Let's see if I can have a look up. Yeah, I mean, that's... Does it look like it flattens out up there? Maybe. If I can get enough speed... Yeah, but I don't want the height, you see. I got flungled up into the air. I didn't want to do that. Come on. I'm on full acceleration here and nothing's happening. There, now it's gushing again, look. The big one's gushing. Out the side. And there's tracks there, look. I obviously went up that side somehow and now I just can't do anything. There's the gusher, there's the gusher. Let's get into it. Yes! Oh, that's just... Oh, what the hell. I don't know where you're taking me. Or if I'll even survive. Oh! That was nasty. Man! So there's geysers here, but they're all in, well, a lot of them are in hard to reach places, and I think the ones that are not gushing so much seem to be in the easier to reach places, like this one down here. Where have you gone? Thank you. I know you're there. I know you're there. I just don't know where you are. Oh, gold. This is really bad terrain. So yeah, you can see I'm on Diso 6BA. Coordinates -100.0 and 45.6. Come on! Nah, no chance. I'll tell you what, those SRV tracks were really handy this time to let me know the path that I'd taken before to get back to where I was. It was... Oh, the strain on the engines, I can almost feel it. It would be nice if every time there was a overstrain like that, it would vibrate the gamepad. Or you feel a vibration every time the thing bumps down. I don't know. There's no gamepad vibration at all in the Elite. Something I never really thought about, to be honest, until just now. I don't know if I even dare or should have dared to do this, but hey. Well, just that my hull is down. I mean, I can easily just either repair it by a synthesis or go into the ship and come back out again. Probably synthesis, as soon as I were in beta. Yeah, could you wash the underside as well? How's that for a roll? So let's just drop down. Not that far. And yeah, actually we can if we do it right. Whoa! What happened there? It just lit up. That's a big one, right? That's a big one. That's a gusher. Should we? I think I'd better note my coordinates before I get before I get flung up there. I tell you what, I don't know if I can be able if I'll be able to do this.
Drive assist on.
Let's see. Oh yes, we did. Hello. Why are you flinging me like that far in the air? And I'm going backwards and backwards and backwards. And down and down and down. Thanks. And I'm facing somewhere. Is that the one? Is that the one that just did it? There's quite a few now. Look at that big gush of air again. That is a cracker. See, it stopped. I think that's what was helping to contribute light up the scene there by the looks of things. What if I go past it really quickly? It's just stopped! No, well, no. Not really, eh? I mean, it stopped gushing, but the pressure was still there. And there's my ship. Can I control where I'm going to land by being... by boosting in the air? Oh, this is not going to be pretty. 27, where the hell? My altitude's still 400 and it's coming down fast. I am trying to level the ship out. We might not survive this, guys. We might not survive this one. Oh, I'm going to have to repair and refuel. So let's just do a standard repair. And a standard refuel.
Fuel replenished.
Fuel repaired. Okay, whatever. It's a cracking thing, isn't it? My ship's there. Facing that way, so the geysers are... Oh, the geysers are down here then. How far away is the ship? God, it's a kilometre! How far did that thing fling me? A kilometre. Over a kilometre, actually. Wow. Come on, sustain, sustain, sustain! Quite away from the ship, and I'm stuck. Oh, there's a rock there. Oh, you. I should have kept the boost going, I would have been alright. Come on. Look at my chassis integrity already. So yeah, this one is an absolute beauty. What if I go over it with half of the SRV? Just this half, just this little bit here. Yeah, you can come down now. It's pretty good. Yeah, you can see the droplets coming back down again. I was wondering if, you know, on higher gravity planets, whether this would change, and I'm sure it does. See if we can get right into it here. Probably fling the camera up in the air now. Does it look like it's just backed off? It has indeed, hasn't it? Yep, it's backed off. It's not as strong as it once was. No, it's calmed down a bit. It's definitely calmed down. And this is brilliant. They've not only implemented this, but they change pressure and stuff like that. Or they have got less... Well, I say they change pressure. This thing switched off before and I went over the top and it flung me up in the air still. Can we get to this other one? I mean, they're not targetable, so you can't measure any distances. But if I can fling myself up here, come on, keep going. Keep going. Okay, so there's another one. And you got the nice sounds as well, so that's pretty cool. So this one, obviously because we must be on the side there like this, so it's flinging out that way. And the gravity is 0.06, but that seems to be dropping itself back down. I wish we were in the day cycle of this planet, so we could see a little bit more of what's going on. And yeah, just glad I've got lights, really. Where's it going to put me down at? Right here. I had to ask. Well, anyway, there we go. A video you can watch just for as long as you're interested. and then you can turn it off anytime. Because I'm just geysering around. Now this one looks very... And indeed, that doesn't even get me off the surface. Ooh! Wait a minute, can I go back up there to it? Just something I want to try. Putting Frontier to the test here. If I go on top of it... I don't know if I can hold it in place there. Have I interrupted the flow? Just by being on top of it? Well, I'm not really on top of it there, am I? Have I capped that well? It looks like... as I come off it. I don't know if I did or not. I mean, it's got about as much power as a something that has got a lot of power. Now, I've not been to this one. This one off to the right of the ship. And that looks a bit of a spouter. Indeed, it is. It's pretty powerful, this one. Oh, it's just backed off. It's great, though, that it does that. You know, Frontier haven't just done it in 5 minutes. They've really... Yeah, they've added a bit more... You can tell there's a bit more work gone into it, a bit more thought. And I appreciate that. And I do like to have these free rides. How far away am I? Oh, it didn't take me very far. Let's try it like this then. Only 30 meters. That was pretty well down there. Okay, so it must be over here. Because my ship is... Well, there's another one in front of me. That's not the one, surely. There it is. Let's have a look over here. I mean, I know they're all the same. But if I can find one that's absolutely gushing like crazy, like the other one we saw, that'll be fun. I did see a video of somebody get a free ride off a geyser, and so you've just got to say, you just got to say geyser. Got a free ride off a geyser. And got shot about 1.2 kilometers up in the air there, upwards. Cheeky barrel roll, or not barrel roll, pitch roll. Oh, that's a spine cruncher. Yeah, so there's plenty to be seen here, and I expect that if we were here in the day cycle, that there would be that it would be quite easily spotted from the air, from maybe a couple of kilometers up or something. Oh, I know. I need to put some power into the weapons. More chromium. At least I haven't destroyed the crystals. Don't destroy the crystals. Sometimes it pays, I think, just to stop and have a little venture outside. Providing you have light, of course, just to see if there's anything around. There's one there, off to my right, but it doesn't look like much. Was this it? Yeah. Yeah, they just look like kind of warts with pus coming. No, never mind. Don't want to talk about that. People might be eating, Rusty. It would be nice if it wasn't like you could see into these things. Well, you can obviously see here that it has a. Yeah, there. Like some kind of half donut, half bagel thing going on. We've got a good run down here. Oh, unbelievable. What timing that was. I just was going to get some boost going. Yeah, less than 50%. You're not kidding. I can't get it. I can't get it. Ah. Oh. I want to land on top of my ship, but I may need the help of a geezer. Oh, what's happened to my lights now? You can't damage them, right? No. Look at that one up the top there. Giving it full bananas. No chance. Why? Because I want to dismiss the ship while I'm on the roof. So, yeah, this is all. I mean, I can't really explore very much more because of the terrain. Let's go into the ship and see if we can scout around in the ASP and see if we can check some other stuff out before we wrap this up. Have I got down there? There we go. Maybe one day they'll fill that black bit in with the actual seat coming out of the SRV and plonking you into the cockpit, Thunderbird style. So we can easily go and check this one now. I don't think it's even the tough ones, even the big gusher ones here have got the power to affect the ship. But hey, I don't know, maybe. Let's fly over it and see. I don't think so. Nothing. But it's nice to know that I'm getting a wash as well as the geyser goes right through my. It seems to have stopped going through my ship. Now it knows that I'm watching it. Actually, no, it's yeah. If you want a internal cockpit wash, then yeah, just come to Diso and they'll do a full valeting service for you, interior and exterior. I wish I could back off the ship from this view. Option in menu, please. Control ship controls available from menu. There you go. And a more powerful headlight would be really, or ship lights, more powerful ship lights would be really nice. Is that the only one here? Where's that big one that we had before? That was off to the right, wasn't it? So I don't know what height you can be at to view these. But this is some tricky terrain here. But in these coordinates, there's quite a few dotted around, as you can see. Quite a lot of inactive ones as well. There's loads of them here, but nothing is really giving out any liquids. Okay. Well, I guess this blackness will probably wrap this up. So there you go. Rusty dogs, fun with geysers. Geysers. I tried to avoid saying that the whole video. Too much innuendo. Fun with geysers. I'm going to have to stick it in my head now. Geysers, geysers, geysers. Recipe for disaster flying like this. I've kind of lost my place, really. I don't really know where I was, but I'm pretty sure I could land anywhere around here and I would be finding some. To scout it from the air by using forward and up thrust while I'm pointing down. I don't know how successful that's going to be. Alright, that wraps it up. Fun with geysers. Fun with spouty things. Oh, that's even worse. Stop it. Bye.